I think there's a lot of different trends that are happening, whether it's measurement or whether it's how buyers and sellers are transacting. But I think what's most important and what has the most implications are how agencies and buyers will start to evaluate the video that they're actually buying in terms of sales, in terms of brand metrics, in terms of different aspects within the overall sales funnel. I think it's a really great mix of buyers, sellers, marketers, some tech providers, but more than anything, it's about the right size. It's not too big, it's not too small, it really is just right. I think you have an issue with measurement. We hear that a lot, that's a known issue, but I think there's, more importantly, it's an issue of valuation. So even if you have a single metric to measure things on, there becomes a question of how is that metric actually valued by the marketer, by the agency, and then making sure that the sellers understand that as well, so that they know where they sit within the overall scope of a media buy. Today, I think it still is probably going to be with the various full episode players, the premium content. As more original programming comes online and it's ad supported, I think you'll see that. But more, what I find really interesting is what's happening in the MCN space with more original programming that isn't how we typically think of programming, whether that's through YouTube or whether that's something else. I think you're going to see a lot more opportunities for branded entertainment, more content marketing, and that's going to be when video starts to really kind of be more than just a 30-second spot.